Joining us for our second hot coffee this morning, ACT Teachers Party List Representative Franz Castro is with us. Congresswoman Castro, good morning. All right, ma'am, you're on mute.
Hi. Good morning, Karen, and to your viewers also.
All right. So, well, what's your initial feedback with the opening of face-to-face classes? You've seen some reports now, and I'm sure you've had initial reports on how it's going.
Karen, I have visited earlier a school in Quezon City, the Apolonio Elementary School. Okay naman yung mga bata, maayos naman yung pagpasok, but my observation is that they are cramped into a small classroom, no? Merong 40 to 50 students in a class. In kindergarten, merong mga 30. So sana hindi ganito, no, Karen? So they should have divided the students into two so that physical distancing could be followed.
So that's in that particular school?
Yes, in that particular school. Later on, I'll go to Batasan, no? So, yun lang yung nakita natin. So, sana ay mahati. Hindi naman necessarily this period, August 22 to October 31, na face-to-face classes na yung lahat. Ang ano naman ng DepEd ay sana ay ano, no, ma-maintain yung physical distancing. Pero may problema kasi tayo, Karen, doon sa memo. Walang ano, no, walang guidelines on the number of students per class.
Mm-mm-mm.
It should have been written in the memo.
Uh-oh.
Na to maintain physical distancing dapat ay 20 to 25 a class kasi talagang nagka-cramp ang mga students sa isang classroom.
Uh-oh. What's actually sad is, of course, being a reporter, I have actually done so many reports and documentaries on education. Yung 50 a class is very typical in the Philippines. When I went to school in a private school, nung grade school and high school, we were 50 in a class. So parang ganun talaga yung sistema sa atin. How do we change this now, Congresswoman, if there's a 91,000 classroom shortage
yes.
all over the Philippines? Diba?
Yes.
How do we do that?
Correct. Pre-pandemic, ang nakita ko, ang bumungad sa akin, parang pre-pandemic time.
Mm.
Which is not to be, dapat na ganon. Talagang magkakaroon ng problema, Karen, doon sa shortage ng mga classroom. Kaya, tapos dumami pa yung mga estudyante. We are expecting, 28 million or 29 million. So, hindi nakahanda. Tingin ko hindi nakahanda pa rin yung ating infrastructure doon sa dagdag ng estudyante at saka yung ganitong para doon sa new normal na sinasabi nila dapat merong enough distance.
Okay, so that's one particular issue is you wanted the DepEd to be clearer to issue a memorandum on just how many students they can take in public schools per classroom. That's one. The next is I wanted to ask you priorities in terms of the coming year. For example, how do we improve our scores? Congressman Romulo said that for primary grades, we should have lesser subjects and focus on reading, math, and good manners and right conduct. Hindi na yung napakaraming subjects because that was the method before.
Yes, Karen, I agree naman ano doon sa sinabi ni Kong Roman. So, tayo ay talagang yung mga bata natin, 10 years old talagang reading comprehension yung problema natin. So, mahalaga yung class size, dapat ma-maintain yung class size para magkaroon ng contact yung teachers sa mga bata, one-to-one at least no, meron tayong ganun. And tama yun din yun but we should use the mother tongue. Ako pa rin, ina-advocate ko pa rin, Karen, yung using a mother tongue from kindergarten to grade 3.
Oo.
Tapos yung English, ma-introduce yan sa grade 4 as a language.
But don't you think that's very late? I mean, I wanna engage with you on this because our scores are very low. I mean, when it comes to international tests, let's face it, right?
Yes.
And frankly speaking, I have two children, and I know for a fact that language is acquired. So the mother tongue is acquired at home. So if it's acquired at home, English is not our primary language as a country. Don't you think yun ang dapat ituro? Isn't that why? Isn't that the reason why our students are faring poorly, frankly, when it comes to tests in English? Because nga, it's taught late.
Yes, meron tayong ano no, barrier doon sa language.
Yeah. So why
ano,
is
other countries use their own language in the test?
Which country? Yeah,
Japan,
but that's not the point. That's not all countries.
Yes.
Which countries are you referring to?
Sa mga ano po, sa mga test, yung mga team, yung mga PISA, some countries are using their mother language or their mother tongue.
What is our mother tongue? We have so many dialects. That will be very difficult.
Yes. So sa ngayon, ano, generally naman yung Filipino, yung ating ano no, yung ating ginagamit.
Oh.
So yun, ganun tayo nagkakaroon tayo ng problema kasi may mga studies na talaga na talagang kapag ipinilit natin yung English agad-agad dun sa bata, pagdating sa mga test, hindi naman talagang naiintindihan. So yun naman yung sinasabi natin na dapat ay yung mother tongue ang gamitin.
All right, now this is a whole other show, but we can talk about that another time. I want to ask you before we go, what is the act party list fighting for in terms of teacher support for this school year?
Yes, so yung ating mga teachers, no, sana ay ano no, magkaroon. Siyempre, 90% na daw yung bakunado. So kailangan ating mga teachers ay makuna. And yung mga teaching supplies, Karen, yung 5,000 kulang yan na gagamitin ng mga teachers natin, lalo na yung internet connection. Sana merong 1,500 a month na internet connection.
Oo. But where would you get the money? Itong 1,500 a month, that would mean that's roughly like 20,000 per teacher a year, right? On additional allowance. Where would you get the money for that?
Yes. Kaya yun po yung ating usal doon sa GAA, sa General Appropriation Act for 2023. Kasi hindi naman tayo malalayo pa rin sa blended learning. So doon po yun. Ano. Tapos so, syempre yung salary grade ng teacher, salary grade 15, yung teacher 1. So yun pa rin yung ating ano, no, para masuportahan natin yung ating mga teachers. Kasi 25,000 pa lang yung ano, no, yung ating pay. Na which, ano, no, layo doon sa mga same qualification ng mga professionals like yung mga nurse, yung ating mga police, mga sundalo, etc. So dapat mailagay sila sa tamang ano no, sa tamang grade.
Yeah.
Tapos meron din kaming proposal na 10,000 medical allowance.
All right. Well, Congresswoman Franz Castro, thank you for joining me today, and I do hope to continue this conversation with you within the week or next week, because it's all going to be about the face-to-face classes, the implementation. So I want to hear your thoughts on that as the week goes on. Thank you so much, ma'am. You take care.
Thank you, Karen.